Well, looky there, this is how it comes. It is on a pallet. We slid it off the semi into my truck. You can see I got a bale of straw there. That's what happens when you're farming too. Anyway, that's how it comes. Give you an idea. And that's not an 8-foot bed, that's a normal bed. I didn't slide it slam to the front, or I could have closed the tailgate. You can tell they just make their own pallets, but it just barely missed. I could have slid it a little further and then I could have closed it, but instead I strapped it. But that'll give you an idea. This is the Kettle cooker, okay, and the table, the sifting table. So it's all there together. This is where you dump your, it's a sifting table. So when you dump the kettle corn machine, show them the kettle corn machine. When you dump that out, it dumps this way into here. And then the little pieces will go into that bin over there, which slides into here. We were looking at this and looking at the legs and seeing the best, you know, how to do this. Basically, it just fits right there. They've got them pre-drilled. And then they come with a bolt and a nut. Come here, Nick. So they come with a wing nut and a bolt. Put the bolt on the inside is what I would tell you to do. And that way you have less surface to hit inside when you're scooping and stirring once you've dumped your kettle corn. So that's it. Tighten those up all the way around and put your four legs on. And then we'll look at this again. Now, how you can tell this didn't come from China is there's exactly enough bolts and wing nuts. You can see we emptied the bag to do all of these. And so you've got four on each leg, and which gives it real good security. It's about an inch and a half overlap each way. You can see that. And then four legs. So you're looking at 16 bolts with wing nuts. And then there's the sifting table, and we're fixing to stand that up. You ready?
Yep.
All right, so I got the kettle cooker. This hose, it has the regulator on the end. They give you plenty of hose. So you could have this way over with your tank, and you could use the, you know, the normal 20-pound tanks, or you could have a big 100-pound cylinder with a little dolly to tow it around if you wanted, depending on the event. This is one of the adapters that screws in. So you pull this red thing off, hang on to it, just so you don't get dirt in here. So when you're done using it, you can put the cap back on, or at least put a piece of electrical tape over it. It's got a gauge for your pressure, and I'll be testing that in a little bit. This, if you notice right here, this has the paddle monkey on it. The paddle monkey is the stirrer. So instead of you sitting there stirring constantly, it stirs for you, and you can pump out kettle corn, you know, pretty dang quick because you don't have to watch it. You just put it in. So you put your oil and corn in, whatever flavorings, and you'd be fired up and ready to go. When you get this, this piece here may be bent. Okay, mine was bent down. So it didn't line up with this. This is just a normal catch, like a door catch. So it goes in there. Come around here. And so it just goes right in there. If it's offset at all, just bend it back into place. And you can also adjust this up or down the way you need it. It's probably already ready. It just maybe these got bent in shipping, and that's no big deal. So that's just so they don't fall on you. Love how this cord comes out the handle, and this is your 110 to operate your Paddle Monkey. Otherwise, you wouldn't need it. So you could hand stir this with a wooden spoon, you know, your wooden paddle, but you'd want to remove the motor and stuff. That'd be two bolts. There's one here and one there, and you could remove this, pull, and your cord would just come with it. Then you could do paddle, but you wouldn't have the benefit of your lids at that point, because that when you get it with the Paddle Monkey is holding is part of the lid system. Now, when you lift this, is and you'll see it's real easy to lift. It's counterbalanced with springs. So I almost pinched my cord. That's something you have to watch for. So this fits snug right up against this if you have it ready. Plus, I didn't have the wheels locked. All four wheels lock, so you can keep this stable. But then when I open this, it's over top of the table. Right now, I don't have it over there. So if you look down here, you've got your pilot. You've got your burner. And then you've got your spring system, which is adjustable if you needed to adjust it. This one feels a little tight on this end, like it's hard to get started, but it feels real good on this end. So the counterbalance is set up pretty good on it. You notice how that doesn't slam? I can let go of that and it doesn't slam. So all that would dump into this table. And already, I have the sifting table underneath that. You can see that as I slide the sifting table under, that catches any of the little Old Maids or the little kernels that come off the side. If you use real cheap popcorn or your kettle is not up to temp, the right temp for popping, it can not fully pop the kernel, which you'll end up with those little wings like normal popcorn does. And those little wings will fall through here. That way you're not giving customers crap corn, I call it. So that's it. That's the whole setup. And it's pretty easy to move. So you can pick this up. There's your front wheels. You've got brakes on these so you can brake them into position. I should have had that done a minute ago. And that's the whole system. So real easy. If you got a little bitty trailer, you could mount it to the trailer, or you could just strap it down. I'm going to be strapping mine into my enclosed trailer. That way, when I arrive, everything's clean. And when I leave, everything stays clean. How this will come is exactly like you see it, as far as it's completely assembled. The only thing that you might have to do is pull your lines, your gas line, and your electric cord out of here. It's stored inside here. And just pull those out. And then this little thing here is for your grease bucket. So you have your grease bucket hanging off, and that's for your fresh grease to go in. And that way, as you ladle it over into here, it doesn't drip down. And what drips and spills off your ladle goes right back into the bucket. It's got a hanger here for the bucket. And this system comes with the bucket, and it's just an aluminum pot, like a turkey pot. And then you got these two big handles, heavy duty handles for pulling it around and pushing it to your location. But that's it.